Scientists in Beijing have developed a new gene therapy which can reverse some of the effects of aging in mice and extended their lifespans, findings which may one day contribute to similar treatment for a human. The specific gene therapy they used and the results were a world first, said co-supervisor of the project, Professor Chu Qing, a specialist in aging and regenerative medicine from the Institute of Zoology at the Chinese Academy of Sciences.
These mice show after 6 to 8 months, they show overall improved appearance and grip strength, and most importantly, they have extended lifespan for about 25%.
The method, detailed in a paper in the Science Translational Medicine Journal earlier this month, involves inactivating a gene called CAT7, which the scientists found to be a key contributor to cellular aging. The team of biologists from different departments at SAS used the CRISPR method to screen thousands of genes in search of those which were particularly strong drivers of cellular senescence, the term used to describe cellular aging. The identified 100 genes out of around 10,000, and CAT7 was one which really stood out. It was the most efficient at contributing to senescence in cells, Chu said.
And our work is to reveal, just to decode the secrecy of aging. So CAT7 may be one of the code.
CAT7 is one of the tens of thousands of genes found in cells of mammals. The researchers inactivated the gene in the livers of the mice using a method called a lentiviral vector. Despite this, the method is a long way from being ready for human trials, Chu said, adding it is necessary to test the function of CAT7 in other cell types of humans and other organs of mice and in the other preclinical animals before using the strategy to the human aging or the other health conditions.
So the short answer is we haven't seen any toxicity yet. And we just test the function of the gene in different kind of cell types, in the human stem cell, the mesenchymal progenitor cells, in the human liver cell and the mouse liver cell. And for all these cells, we didn't see any detectable cellular toxicity. And for the mice, we also didn't see any side effect yet. But yeah, it deserves to further investigate and to evaluate it. I think we don't understand the nature of aging yet. So we cannot say we disobey that. We firstly need to understand what aging is and like how long we eventually can get to live, right? And then maybe it's not the truth that we disobey nature. We just find the reason, the secrets to make ourselves live longer.
Chu said she hopes to be able to test the method on primates next, but it would require a lot of funding and much more research first.
And in the end, we do hope we can find a way to delay aging. Even by very minor percentage, we want to delay the human aging in the future.